حرر النفس ولا تحيا هباء يا ربيعا أنت والعطر الرداء خذ قرارا وانطلق لا تنتظر ليس كل الناس أهل للعلاء خذ
Yes, Maulana, you have a question?
Yeah, Maulana, can you just clear the air regarding, you know, this notion which is going around our, you know, youngsters regarding just following Qur’an and authentic ahadīth? Can you just please spread shed a bit of light on this, please?
Yes, inshallah, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Basically, what Maulana is asking Maulana Abdul Haleem Sahib is that this is a sort of a new trend amongst the youngsters especially. And you have this trend, the presence of this trend, mainly on social media and online, that, akhi, you only follow Qur'an and authentic hadith. Is that the right question, Maulana?
Yeah, that's it.
I just want to shed a few points regarding this question and the answer. The statement of following Qur'an and authentic hadith only, that, akhi, you only follow Qur'an and authentic hadith, this statement in itself is against Qur'an and Hadith. This statement in itself is against Qur'an and Hadith. This is a challenge. A challenge, you know, in a very humble level. That there's not a single Hadith in the entire compilation of Ahadith, in the entire Zakhira of Ahadith, but the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, follow Qur'an and authentic Hadith only. There's not a single Hadith like this. Rather, a person, Maulana, who actually advocates and propagates this notion, they don't even understand the basic translation of Surah Fatiha. The surah that they read five times a day. In Surah Fatiha, what do we say? We say, اِهْدِنَ الصَّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, that, oh Allah, guide us to the straight path. Which is the straight path? صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ, the path of those upon whom you bestowed your blessings. The path of those whom you bestowed your blessings. Now, who are these people that walk on this path? Who are they? Now, this is undisputed. There's no difference. That the strongest form of Quranic exegesis and tafsir is when the Quran explains itself. Al-Quran yufassir ba'duhu ba'da. So we search in the Quran. Where has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elaborated those people who walk on this path? صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم. So we'll find the fifth juz, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وَحَسْنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. That there are four categories, four types of people. Nabiyyin, the prophets. Siddiqeen, those that speak the truth. Shuhada, the martyrs. And Salihin, the righteous ones. So, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم, O Allah, the path of those upon whom you bestowed your blessings, are these four people, the Nabiyeen, Siddiqeen, Shuhadan, Salihin. Now, if only following Quran and Hadith, or Quran and the Prophet only, then Allah would have said, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, صراط الحديث, صراط الرسول, Surah Fatiha complete. But no, Allah prolonged the text, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. This in itself, this indication, a very subtle ishara, that is not only Quran, authentic hadith. Number one. Number two, in the ahadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he explicitly said the opposite. Not the opposite, but I wouldn't say opposite, but something different. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, follow my sunnah, alaykum bi sunnati, my sunnah and the sunnah of my righteous guided khulafa, the sahaba, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali radiyallahu anhu ajma'in. My sunnah and the sunnah of my sahaba. This is an authentic hadith. Now the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used the word sunnah for his actions and the word sunnah for the actions of the sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala ajma'in. Now the question arises, if it was only hadith, the Prophet would have said, only follow alaykum bi hadithi as-sahih, Bukhari, Muslim, wa Tirmidhi. No, you don't find this. He's mentioned the word sunnah for his actions and the action of the sahaba. So let me give you an example. I'm not going to discuss the issue of Taraweeh, but somebody will say, the Akhi, yes, 20 rakat Taraweeh is from Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, but is there a hadith, authentic hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Without going into the issue of Taraweeh, let's hypothetically, bil farad wal mahal, imagine that there is no hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Even then, the action of Umar radiallahu ta'ala an in itself, the action in itself is sunnah. Why? Who is saying this? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself is saying this. So we are told to follow sunnah of the Prophet and the Sahaba. Let me give you a same. Alawa Shaykh Hadi rahmatullah alayhi would give a beautiful example. I don't want to go into the nitty gritty, what is sunnah, what hadith. He would say, ki jahan pe Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam ne koi kaam kiya ho, aur saath saath sahaba ya ba sahaba ko lekar gaya ho, to wo sunnat hai. Now, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam carried out a specific action, and the sahaba, or some of the sahaba, internalized and carried out the action with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this is sunnah. But where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did an action on his own, and nobody amongst the sahaba internalized, acted upon that action is not sunnah, even though it's in the hadith. Give you an example, there's a full chapter in Bukhari. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he stood up and he urinated. Babul Bawli Qa'iman. There's four hadith. Approximately four hadith, if I'm not mistaken, under this chapter. Now, there's not a single hadith in the Bukhari. Yes, in other works, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam sat down and he urinated. But what's the sunnah?
To sit down.
But isn't the hadith standing? In the hadith, Babul Salat fi Na'alain, there's a chapter in Bukhari, full chapter to read your salah with shoes. Now in England, December or January, winter, an akhi, we have an akhi, he walks inside the masjid with his shoes on, muddy, full of mud. It's snowing, for example, it doesn't snow that much anymore, but back in the, you know, 10-15 years ago, it used to snow a lot, especially in Bradford. And he walks inside with his muddy shoes and he's walking under the new carpet. And the committee members or the imam says, Ya Allah, Ya akhi, ittaqi Allah, what you're doing, fear Allah, you are polluting, you are making the new carpet dirty, says Aki. Fear Allah, you are stopping me from acting upon full chapter of Bukhari. Babu Salat fi Na'alain. Full chapter in Bukhari, you are stopping me from this. What will happen to him? He'll be rahmatullahi alayhi in that masjid. Yes. So we are told to follow Quran and Sunnah. And Sunnah is very broad. To Sunnah of the Prophet, Sunnah of the Sahaba, and also the Khairul Qurun, the action of the first generation there also. That's why one brother came to me, this is a final point, one brother came to me and he said, he was asking for Quran and Hadith. Hadith only. Authentic Hadith. I said, according to who? Authentic Hadith according to? According to whom? So it was like, you know, when you have a wheel spinning 100 miles per hour and then you put a spanner in. He just stopped, he froze. He was perplexed, confused, flabbergasted completely, didn't know what to say. I said, according to Imam Bukhari, he's got a criteria of authentic hadith. Imam Muslim's criteria is different. Imam Abu Dawud's criteria is different. So which authentic hadith are you talking about? Can you please explain? Yes, if the Prophet alayhi salam, if Allah or his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself said that this hadith is authentic, ala ra'si wal ayn, we will accept that, we will not argue. No Muslim will have any second opinion about that. Because Allah said, or the Prophet said. But if a muhaddith, with all due respect, who came after the first three generations, Khairul Qurun, and the era after the first three generations were of corruption, fasad, if he says a hadith is authentic, we will respect his view. But hasha wa kalla, will we ever jeopardize or sacrifice the opinion of that person who came in the Khairul Qurun and the first three golden eras? Yes. So this is a very important point that we need to understand. Mawlana, I hope that answered your question.
Yeah. Mawlana, can I just make a quick point here? You know, this hadith that you just mentioned about sunnati wa sunnati al-khulafai al-rashidin. There are some scholars who actually said that, you know, from this hadith we can understand that the sunnah of Sahaba and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is actually one sunnah. And the reason is because if you follow on the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, "Addu alayha." Instead of saying "Addu alayhima," he says "Addu alayha."
Subhanallah.
Which shows that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is actually saying that both of them are one thing. The sunnah of Sahaba and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That actually one thing, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam referred to them as one thing and not two, because if he wanted to differentiate between them, he would have said addu alayhima.
Subhanallah.
So just a quick point. Just
that's a very good point. May Allah ta'ala reward Maulana Abdul Haleem. Just a point with the Arabic grammar, that Aliha, the pronoun Aliha is referring to the Sunnah in general. Yani the Sunnah of the Prophet and the Sahaba in general together is one Sunnah. May Allah reward you for that, Maulana Abdul Haleem. Jazakum Allah, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.